Hey folks, it's me, Screamin' Sammy Scatch, aka The Scatch Man, coming at you again from PAX South 2016, and I am sitting down here talking to Christian. Christian, you are the co-creator of Moving Hazard. What is Moving Hazard?
Yes, Moving Hazard is a multiplayer tactical military shooter with zombies thrown into the mix. It's basically Counter-Strike meets The Walking Dead. And before you say, oh no, another shooter game, let me add that we also have something particularly unique to the game, which is we give you the ability to manipulate and control the zombies so you can turn them into a weapon to use against your enemy.
Where did the idea for that come from? The idea of not only putting these zombies in there as a problem, but also allowing the players to manipulate them?
Well, clearly, you know, myself and Rocco Scandizzo, the co-creator of the game with me, we wanted to do something original with the idea of using zombies and telling a story with zombies. And so much good work has been down there, from The Walking Dead to 28 Days Later to the work of George Romero, who created the whole thing. We just wanted to say our own piece and try to do something original and pay respect to the great work that's been done. And so, you know, we looked at the world of the military and why the military are never really exposed to the zombie apocalypse. You never really seem to see them be effective or do anything great other than run away and hide and be, you know, without weapons and resources. So we kind of started from there and created a world where the military has created the zombie virus. They created the zombie virus as a weapon of mass destruction to deploy over the enemy encampment as some kind of Agent Orange, so that our enemies would just eat each other, and no bullets, no drones, no anything. And what can go wrong with that, right? That also explains why you as a player have these tools that you can use to corral, manipulate, and turn the zombies into your weapons. And then, of course, something goes wrong, the virus mutates, and before you know it, it's zombie apocalypse. The game takes place 50 years after the outbreak, and the world is basically only military. You know, the military have fortified their bases, there's no more governments, there's no more allegiances, so each big military base has turned into a city-state, and if you want to have their protection, if you want to live inside these nice, safe zones, you have to serve, you have to join their ranks, and you have to do your tour of duty. And your tour of duty involves fighting zombies, but primarily fighting the other human factions.
So in this case, you have these military factions are at odds with each other, sort of like warring city-states?
Yes. Yes, the world kind of went medieval to each other, and so the military had all these resources, helicopters, gasoline, backup power, doctors, and so they just created, they fortified their bases. Like, imagine Camp Pendleton. They just took all that territory, built big walls around it, and said, who's in is in, and who's out is out. And in that particular military base became the SoCal Protectorate.
Gotcha. All right. What is adding a third neutral faction that sort of wants to kill everybody? How does that change the gameplay?
It adds a level of dynamism to the game that it's really hard to find when you are just player versus player. First of all, it allows you to be always on the move, allows the player to always have something to do. You can't be disengaged from the game. Even if a human enemy is not in your sights, you always have the zombies to deal with. And so that kind of keeps the game moving. It takes care of camping, it takes care of a lot of like little undesirable elements of traditional first-person shooters. And on top of that, it gives you, with the tools that we've deployed, it gives you the ability to actually turn them to your advantage.
So talk about some of those tools. I just got done playing the demo and I saw like the pheromone grenades and stuff. How did you design those? Like, was that the goal, to make sure that we can manipulate these, or was it like, let's look at first-person items and sort of just move them over? Like, how did they get developed?
They got created with the idea of what can we do with zombies. To use them as an advantageous foe. First of all, we looked at what you can actually do. You can fundamentally break it down into three classes. You can move. You can have the zombies attack your enemies. You can move the zombies around at will. and you can be defended from them. So in these three categories, then we created fun items that we thought would be really enjoyable for the player to play with. The pheromone attractive Molotov PAM is our bread and butter sort of tool of the trade. You throw it to the zombies, you spray them in this cloud of pheromones that activates the compounds that are already in the virus that were designed by the military to attack. And okay. It just trains them on your enemy. And so basically the zombies will just turn into hounds of war and they will run and they'll try to sniff out the smell of your enemy and then they'll attack. And it's actually pretty good fun to chase them and see where they're going. And they're a good way to locate enemies if the map is big and there's only two or three players. They'll actually take you to them.
That's amazing.
So that's obviously like an attack weapon. Then we have something like the LRAD that is also in this demo here at PAX. You put it down, it's sort of almost like a buoy that you deploy on the ground. And what that does is that it emits these electromagnetic waves that attract the zombies to its location and calms them down. So they don't attack you, but they sort of protect the area where you've deployed this tool. And this is great for like Capture the Flag or King of the Hill, where you put this down and for a certain amount of time you have a human wall of zombies protecting your little flag.
So you had mentioned several different game modes, King of the Hill, things like that. What kind of game modes besides King of the Hill are you looking at?
So right now we have three maps and three modes, and the three modes are King of the Hill, Capture the Flag, and Team Deathmatch. And that's what we're going to go out on Steam with and Steam Early Access. Then when we release the game, we're planning on releasing six maps with four modes, and we're going to add a horde mode that you can also play in single player.
Oh, awesome.
So that you can kind of learn a few of these tools and get better at shooting without the competitive aspect of the game that inevitably with a game like this comes up when you're playing online.
No doubt. When are you looking to get on Steam?
So in about a month we'll be on Early Access. It'll be $20, so people can just jump on, get three maps, three modes, and kind of really help us balance the game. The game is going to be as polished as it can be. We don't want to kind of put something out there that has bugs and treat our audience as testers. We actually want to get positive feedback that helps us balance the game, see what people really enjoy playing with, see what needs to be tweaked or taken out and replaced with something better, and then we will release the final game a few months after that.
Where can people follow along? Is there a website?
Yeah, the website is movinghazard.com.
Movinghazard.com. Christian, thank you so much for chatting with me.
Thank you.
I hope you have an amazing PAX, sir.
You, and same to you.
Thanks.